Immortals Fenyx Rising DLC has been announced by Ubisoft. The trailer details the quest and lore that will come after the game's release on December 3rd. The DLC is split up into three expansions, the first of which is called A New God, and has Fenyx compete the Trial of the Olympians with puzzles and combat. The second installment, Myths of the Eastern Realm, has players explore Chinese mythology through the eyes of a new character. And the third expansion, The Lost Gods, focuses on yet another new character's relationship with Fenyx and restoring balance to the land. The 2020 Game Awards nominations have been announced, and we are able to see what games are going to be fighting for the coveted Game of the Year award. The titles nominated for Game of the Year are Animal Crossing New Horizons, Doom Eternal, Final Fantasy VII Remake, Ghost of Tsushima, Hades, and The Last of Us Part 2. In addition to many other awards, such as Best Art Direction and Best Studio Design, a new award has been announced for Innovation and Accessibility for games that most consider gamers with disabilities or impairments. Some standout games have appeared for more than just one category. Hades has been nominated in 9 award categories, and The Last of Us 2 has been nominated for 10. IO Interactive, the developers behind the critically acclaimed Hitman series, announced a 007 game as their next project. For those unfamiliar with the Hitman games, it features cloak and dagger-like gameplay about a professional assassin. Needless to say, IO Interactive seems to have the right stuff to develop a James Bond game. The game is set to be an entirely original James Bond story and is to detail the origin of the famous British spy. London's Oxford Circus has had some redecorating done by PlayStation. The tube signs were given the PlayStation symbols as part of their appearance, and game names were integrated into London's tube stations. Mile End was temporarily turned into Miles End after Spider-Man Miles Morales, and Lancaster Gate was transformed into Ratchet and Clankcaster Gate. The PlayStation Underground symbols are already gone, but the tube station names will stick around until December 16th. Assassin's Creed Valhalla's Day 1 player count was higher than Odyssey. Adding to the impressive feat is the fact that Odyssey had set its own record for the most successful launch week in Assassin's Creed history until Valhalla came out on November 10th. The game has received decent reviews, with a few bugs marring the experience. However, that did not stop more players than ever from booting up the Viking adventure on their systems during its release.